A U.S. State Department official expresses concern over China's use of intimidation in its maritime row with the Philippines. He made the comment as China accused the U.S. of using the Philippines as a pawn to destabilize the South China Sea. Bianca Daba has this story.
Beijing accuses Washington anew of being a troublemaker in the South China Sea. This after the U.S. condemned China's latest maritime aggression against Philippine vessels that left four Filipino Navy personnel injured.
China urges the U.S. to refrain from using the Philippines as a pawn to destabilize the South China Sea. The Philippines also needs to refrain from being manipulated by the U.S. Lessons from history tell us that a pawn will only end up being abandoned.
The U.S. State Department, meanwhile, asserts Washington will maintain its presence in Southeast Asia.
The United States continues through our own operations to be physically present in the region on a daily basis, and we continue to fly, sail, and operate everywhere that international law allows, demonstrating thereby that all countries share those same rights.
The U.S. State Department also criticized China's recent actions as destabilizing.
I think we've seen in a number of instances where the People's Republic of China has taken a number of steps in the South China Sea that both run counter to international law, but that also utilize coercion to intimidate partners in ways that we find deeply unacceptable and destabilizing.
Meanwhile, the AFP Western Command reported a significant decrease in Chinese presence at the vicinity of Ayungin Shoal following last Tuesday's harassment of a military resupply mission. WESCOM Commander Vice Admiral Alberto Carlos says there are only one Chinese Coast Guard vessel and two Chinese militia vessels near the shoal as of Thursday morning, down from 26 last Tuesday. Carlos was on board Unaiza May 4 when it bore the brunt of a water cannon attack by the China Coast Guard on Tuesday, said the voyage aimed to check whether the vessel can enter the low tide elevation.
Ito yung first time sana na gagamitin natin. Itetest muna natin sana kung makakapasok sa Ayungin Shoal kasi deeper yung draft dito eh. Mas malalim than the other Unaiza May. Almost doble sa laki.
Although it was its first voyage to Ayungin Shoal, Unaiza May 4 had already been to two previous test missions in Cuyo and Balabac in Palawan. Carlos said the civilian boat is now undergoing repair.
Nothing major yung repair, only the replacement of yung windshield, madali lang naman yan. And then yung mga CCTV cameras na nasira, madali din naman palitan yan. Mabuti na kalagayan nila. Sabi ko nga, minor injuries lang naman yan. Napacheck na namin sa station hospital namin dito sa WESCO. Minor din naman yung mga cuts nila sa mga braso, hindi naman sa delikadong lugar.
The AFP will stick to using Unaiza May boats in future resupply missions. Carlos added, Unaiza May 1, which was able to reach the BRP Sierra Madre in the last mission, is scheduled for repair as some parts of the boat have started to deteriorate. Unaiza May 2 is also still under repair after it was hit by the China Coast Guard in last year's mission.
May scheduled repairs lang siya na kailangan na gawin, maintenance ng makina, some hull repairs, may mga medyo mahina ng parte ng hull na ababa na naman, above waterline, papalitan natin kasi kahoy siya. We have other options, pinag-aaralan namin. Ang una dyan is kung we will stick to the UMs, i-manage ka natin yung load in terms of frequency ng rore, in terms of kung gaano karami ang ikakarga natin.
Carlos said the morale of his men remains high despite China's latest harassment. Meanwhile, two analysts agree with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s statement that the latest water cannon incident is not enough to invoke the country's mutual defense treaty with the United States.
Malinaw po nakalagay sa MDT at doon din sa mga statement ng US at Philippines since that time, no? Ang requirement po ay an armed attack, no? Armed attack on Philippine ships, troops or aircraft, no? So Sa ngayon po, yung paggamit ng water cannon at na pagkabasag ng windshield, hindi pa po yun umaabot dun sa armed attack. Kung ibang pwede pang gawin ang Philippines and United States sa dahil sa mga ganyang klaseng activity. Kung ano po yun, ay hindi po yun parang kailangan pag-usapan sa publiko, no? Dahil ano nga naman, sino ang pwede na bawat hakbang mo, eh, pinapasabi mo, pinapaalam mo agad sa kabila. I agree. Kasi yung MDT should be the last resort. Yung grabing-grabe na, wala ka nang maisip. Kasi right now, ang dami pa nating intervention. Unang-una, of course, no, yung diplomacy, tama yung ginagawa ng ating presidente ngayon. He's gaining support from a union of like-minded countries. Hindi lang ang Estados Unidos yung gustong umalalay sa atin. Nandiyan na si Australia, si Japan, tapos yung European Union, tapos yung mga kapitbahay natin in Southeast Asia, lumalakas yung collective deterrence natin.
Despite the latest incident, the AFP and the Philippine Coast Guard stressed they will continue to bring supplies and to rotate troops at the BRP Sierra Madre and to maintain Philippine presence in the West Philippine Sea. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News.